picture this. A 36-year-old woman ends up developing COVID, gets tested, tests positive, but she's doing fine and she's just told to recover at home, and she does recover. But then a few weeks later, she starts developing really, really problematic and honestly disabling symptoms, including dizziness, extreme fatigue, brain fog, shortness of breath, presyncope, and fainting. She goes to her doctor and they can't figure out what's wrong. It continues to get worse. She ends up being tested for POTS with a tilt table test and does in fact have POTS, or postural orthostatic tachycardia syndrome. You can think about it as an intolerance to standing, even though it's so much more than that. It's a type of dysautonomia, or autonomic dysfunction, and the autonomic nervous system controls things that you do not need to think about, such as breathing, dilating your pupils, digestion, circulating your blood and blood pressure. So you can imagine if there's a problem with it, that can cause a lot of symptoms. And POTS is the most common type of dysautonomia. When somebody is tested for POTS, the main way that they're tested is through something called a tilt table test, or a poor man's tilt table test. It's basically where you lie down and you're either on a platform that tilts you up or you stand up, and they look to see how much your heart rate increases and any changes in your blood pressure or anything else. In somebody with POTS, typically they'll have at least a 30 beat per minute increase in heart rate just from going from lying down to standing, somewhere within 10 minutes. Also, that heart rate is sustained. You know, it's not like you like meh, back down. It can be, you know, really weird and stuff, but it doesn't just like suddenly jump up and then you're fine. You do feel symptomatic. For people that are younger than something like, I want to say 18 or 19, it's actually a 40 beat per minute increase in heart rate that they're looking for. Somebody without POTS does actually experience a little increase in heart rate when they stand up, as well as a bit of an increase in blood pressure. But typically with heart rate, it only increases around 10 to 15 beats per minute when they stand up, and it really shouldn't cause much symptoms. I do know it is normal to some extent to sometimes stand up and feel your vision go a little weird or feel a bit dizzy. It happens to everybody, but with POTS, that happens literally every time you stand up, and it's so much worse than that. It lasts a lot longer, and you can faint and develop other symptoms from that. So up to around 50% of people with POTS, depending on what study you look at, develop POTS as a result of a viral illness. And many times that could be something like mono. And then sometimes people have an autoimmune disorder, such as lupus or Sjogren's, that cause it. And sometimes you can't figure out the cause. So I do in fact have POTS. My POTS is caused by hypermobile Ehlers-Danlos Syndrome, or hypermobile EDS, which is a genetic condition that I have. Though I actually also started, you know, having worsening symptoms of POTS after I had mono. So I started developing symptoms of POTS at the age of 14, and they progressively got worse. And then at 19, I had mono, and a few months later it got even worse and I started going into presyncope every single day. So I can understand how just a simple virus can, or maybe not a simple virus, but a virus can really impact it. And it actually really worries me about my safety and the safety of others who have POTS. You know, could it make it worse for the people who already have it? So while reading around and looking at dysautonomia international statements, it seems like there's no evidence that POTS can put somebody at a greater risk of having a severe illness or any complications as a result of COVID-19. It's just that there's a lot of people who are in fact developing POTS because of COVID-19. Though it does say that just like with any virus, your POTS can temporarily get worse, mainly due to dehydration. So just keep that in mind. That's just what I've been reading from Dysautonomia International and the statements that they've made regarding COVID-19. So there are some studies talking about why people are developing POTS. It's not that they totally know, but there are four reasons from a study I was reading that they're tossing around, and they all correspond to basically all the types of POTS that are most common. So the first mechanism for potentially developing POTS after COVID-19 relates to hypovolemia, which is low blood volume. So when somebody has COVID-19, having a fever, having nausea, excessive sweating, especially at night, and then prolonged bed rest might lead to a decrease in blood volume, so the amount of blood that's circulating around your body. Plus deconditioning, because you're not moving, can make it even worse. So that's one one potential mechanism. I know that hypovolemic POTS is kind of the type of POTS I have, but I don't really know how easily my type actually fits into a category because it really does have an underlying cause of Ehlers-Danlos syndrome. So I just kind of like, I'm loosely diagnosed, you know, with the hypovolemic POTS, but you know. Neuropathic POTS. This is where the virus somehow messes with your small fiber nerves, and these nerves control the constriction of blood vessels in your limbs and your abdomen. So when you stand up, you know, you're supposed to have constriction of blood vessels to prevent all your blood from just falling down to your feet. But if you have some sort of dysregulation of that, it can be really problematic within the body. The next potential method is related to hyperadrenergic POTS. And to be completely honest, this one's really, really confusing. But it says here that the idea is the virus can somehow invade the brain stem and alter functions of, it says, I don't fully understand this, but medullary centers, resulting in increased central sympathetic outflows. All of these, by the way, lead to an increased like sympathetic outflow. Whatever that really means, it's referring to the sympathetic nervous system. It's, you know, adrenaline gets released, especially in this type. You can have things like adrenaline surges, and people with this type can have like really high blood pressure suddenly. And the last potential mechanism relates to autoimmunity. So when talking about a virus, I'm actually just gonna read what they say. So in response to a viral infection, immune responses targeting the virus are regulated in a complex dynamic way, balancing attacking the virus versus attacking your own cells. So POTS could result from the disruption of this delicate balance. It's called dyshomeostasis. So around 25% of people who have POTS, depending on the study you look at, it could be a lot more than that or even less, have autoantibodies. And many of those people have autoantibodies to something really specific. It's called antiganglionic acetylcholine receptor autoantibodies, in case you were wondering. I'm sure you were not. And this can relate and potentially cause POTS. So those are the four underlying mechanisms that people are, you know, proposing, and they're very basically the same like ones that are just the normal causes of POTS, but they're just relating it to COVID-19. While editing this, I just wanted to say that people oftentimes don't know which type of POTS they have, and very frequently people will kind of have a combination, and sometimes it's not clear at all, and that does not always matter. Like I said, when I asked my cardiologist once, she was like, you kind of fall underneath the category of hypovolemic POTS. But the thing is if you read certain studies, they will classify joint hypermobility related POTS or Ehlers-Danlos syndrome related POTS as a different category too. It really just depends on where you look. Even though I'm not at an increased risk of developing, you know, a severe problem because of COVID, if I were to get it, this is really my number one fear. I am so scared, you know, because I know how bad POTS is. I know how bad it can be. I do take treatment. I'm on propranolol, and then I take midodrine sometimes, but my blood pressure has actually been so good that I don't take it every day at all. I just like take it whenever I feel like I need it, like when my blood pressure is low. And then I also increase my salt intake. I increase my water intake. Sometimes I get really nauseous, so I have nausea meds, and I also use compression stockings. So, you know, there are ways that I can change around my life and do certain things to manage the symptoms, and it does help. My hope for this is that better treatments and maybe better understanding of some of the causes of POTS and maybe even preventative measures somebody can take can be discovered during this time, since more people are developing POTS. I also really hope that the people who are developing POTS as a result of COVID-19 only develop it temporarily. From my readings in the past, and I'm gonna see if I can find some of the studies and stick it down below in the description that say this. They say that if you have developed POTS as a result of a viral illness, that it tends to go away within a few years, as opposed to some of the other types don't go away or like take a long time to get better. So I'm sorry if you're one of these people dealing with this. I know how scary it can be when you develop a condition, especially if you've been healthy before and you don't know what it's like to be ill. I mean, I guess I can give you a little insight, but nobody should have to deal with this. So I'm really sorry that this is what you're going through. You know, there are things that you can do to make it better, like I mentioned, and there are really good doctors out there. You know, I think we've all with POTS been told that our symptoms are in our heads. They're told that it's literally just anxiety and there's nothing wrong. We've all been told that, let's be honest. But once you do get that diagnosis and the correct treatments, for me at least, and for many people, there have been improvements. Oh, something else I didn't mention is And this is really helpful for a lot of people too. I used to get saline infusions where they would just, you know, intravenously infuse saline to increase, basically like increase my blood volume, and that was really helpful, plus increases your blood pressure because of salt. So just, I wanna let you know that there is hope, but it is really hard no matter what. If you do have POTS, I would love to hear down below in the comments how it started for you. Do you also have hypermobile Ehlers-Danlos Syndrome or another type? I know a lot of people obviously on my channel have that because I talk about it, but because so many people also get it from viruses and other things as well, I would love to hear your story if you want to share it. I also really would recommend that if you don't already know somebody with POTS, I would highly suggest trying to connect with somebody if you think that's something that would be helpful for you, because I know how helpful it was for me to meet somebody and meet others who literally completely understand what it's like. So I would highly recommend checking out some Facebook groups for POTS. Even if you want some friends, comment down below and maybe some other people would like to connect with you through something such as Instagram. So thanks for joining me on this video, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye!